Hi, Rick Nolan, member of Congress from Minnesota's 8th Congressional District.
How long have you been in this position here?
Well, I served in the Congress in the 70s, and I took a little 32-year hiatus in business and community service. I came back in 2012, so I've been here the last three terms, in my third term.
I know you love this area, and I know you love the Great Lakes. What are some of the biggest concerns that you have right now about the Great Lakes?
Well, first of all, I can't resist not putting in a plug for Duluth, Minnesota. I was recently recognized as the fittest city in America.
You mean exercising fit, healthy people who wake up early in the morning, the obnoxious people I see
by
running.
Fitbit. Okay.
You're one of those people who runs at 6 a.m. along the bay.
Oh, now God, they're running everywhere here. It was also recognized as the happiest city in America.
Why do you think that is?
I think there are a lot of good-paying jobs. People here don't have to work as hard as although they're a hard-working bunch, as a lot of the rest of the country. They have more time for family and friends and leisure and more things that are fun and interesting and exciting to do than most cities.
And recreation and beauty and enjoying the lakes. I mean, I see people out kayaking this morning. It just seems like it's part of their lives.
Oh, it is. Outdoor Magazine recently concluded that Duluth was the best outdoor city in America. So we got a lot to brag on.
And there's a lot of reason to be worried about the future of the Great Lakes, so to make sure it stays pristine and clean for the future.
Absolutely. Lake Superior and, of course, the Great Lakes are crucial to all of this. And there are a number of really big, important issues. One, of course, is the locks at Sault Ste. Marie and their importance to our national security, our national economy, our well-being, jobs, and ability to the businesses and the mining and the forestry and the agriculture of this region to get out of Lake Superior and into the Great Lakes, where we help feed the world, supply the steel mills, who in turn supply the automobile and the heavy industrials. It's in terrible disrepair, and it needs to be replaced. It's so important that we have also military protection there. They tell us that if it failed, it would throw the country into a Great Depression. That's how important that is. We also have been embarking upon a great program to restore the Great Lakes, and why, I don't know, but the Republicans in Congress, in their budget proposals, and the President proposed to stop funding the Great Lakes restoration, the Sea Grants program. We also have been working on an initiative to make sure that the Harbor Trust Fund is not raided by the Office of the Presidency and used for other purposes. We got a 10-year backlog on dredging, and there's $9 billion that the ships, or lakers as we call them, have paid into a fund for dredging and harbor maintenance, and over $9 billion have been raided from that fund. And we keep getting stalled on efforts to make sure that that fund is used for what it was set up for, which is harbor maintenance, dredging, and facilitating the flow of commerce through our Great Lakes. The Lakers are only operating at 80% of capacity because of the lack of harbor maintenance. The money's there. We've got to stop using it for other purposes. And then lastly, and maybe most important of all, is the whole issue of climate change. There are projections that the Great Lakes temperatures could rise by as much as 11 degrees. And that would dramatically and quite adversely affect the fishing industry, the commerce industry. It would help facilitate the growth of more of these invasive species. And it's something that we have to address, not only for the Great Lakes, but, you know, perhaps the survival of our species here on Earth. So those, you know, the new locks, the harbor maintenance, the climate change, and the Great Lakes restoration, the Sea Grant programs are all important to preserve and protect this unbelievably great natural resource, and to do it in a way that continues to enhance the flow of commerce, which is so important to improving our lives and creating good paying jobs and laying a foundation for business. There are many of us, myself included, believe that we have the knowledge, the ability to do both, have commerce, have beauty, protect our environment. One without the other, you probably have enough.